How do you feel about being 90?
It's okay.
Yeah. It's okay.
I feel like, but I just...
How old do you feel, really? Like 60, 30?
Well, it's okay. I'm 90. I just do the best I can do to work.
You exercise.
Yeah.
Well, you look so beautiful.
Mm. It's all hard work. Mm-hmm. They are locked down on me in my barrio. Mm-hmm. She's always wearing the same clothes.
Oh my goodness.
I was a teacher already, but how can I afford to buy good clothes when I'm using my money? I give it to my parents to buy food, to buy clothing. So that is why I really didn't want to get married right away.
Mm-hmm. Once upon a time, a girl with moonlight in her eye.
Oh, we are from the same town.
Oh.
One time, there was a fiesta in Buhon, in one of the towns. So we were there. I think it's there that he saw me. We went to the dance. Mm-hmm. And then he wanted to get married.
Right away.
I said, I don't think I will go through the wedding because, you know, I was the only supporter in the family.
But that was once upon a time.
So I changed my mind. Okay, let us have the wedding on the 3rd. And after the wedding, after my class, vacation class, I went to Manila. And that's it. We were there in Manila. Mm. Having boys.
Yeah.
Came here, I have $4,000. And the exchange in those days was 3 to 1, 3 pesos to $1. So all my work in the Philippines, I was saving it. Mm-hmm. And so was Edwin. He is also another one. So we were able to buy a house right away the second week when we came here. Second week we bought a house in San Francisco. I was not afraid because I know the opportunities here in America. Mm-hmm. Like Edwin. That's how I found the one of those girls who was going from house to house. They were telling me, you have a beautiful house. This will make a good rest home.
Mm.
That's how I found out about rest home.
Wow.
So he said, what is a rest home? I said, it is a home where you take care of older people, give their medicine, take them to the doctor, and see that they are okay. I said, that's no problem because we do that in the Philippines with our old people.
Yeah,
we do that. Mm-hmm. And most of our friends from my office and from Edwin's office, they are at the airport, they will call us, Edwin, pick us up at the airport. We have no place to go.
Wow.
So we will go to the airport, pick them up, mm-hmm. they stay with us until they find a job. Some of my relatives will come into America, like Lydia and Nick.
Mm-hmm.
I said, okay, you can have this house. You can have this house at the bottom, but you have to take care of the people.
Mm.
Cook for them and give their medicine. And I always tell my sisters in the Philippines, if you want to come to America, do not get married.
Mm-hmm.
Or you will not be able to come. So all of them remain single.
Mm.
Elisa was already a teacher. Jaime was a teacher. He was already here. Wilson was only 3 years old. Dado was 5. They cannot go to school yet. They always tell me when I come home from work, they will always tell me, Mom, we went to Chinatown. We went to Candlestick Park because the bus was very cheap.
Mm-hmm.
I said, who is taking care of these young kids? Oh, we do. I said, then every time I come home from work, they will tell me, oh, we went again to Chinatown. You know, Chinatown is a very crowded place.
Mm-hmm.
The parking lot is so crowded. So that's why I said, okay. So I put in my mind, always in San Francisco, it's nice. I like San Francisco, but I said, it's not good for the boys. So I told Edwin, Edwin, we better go to the farm, have these boys stay in the farm, mm-hmm. not city of San Francisco. Mm-hmm. Yes. So when we came and looked at the place here, for it was for sale, we bought it right away. Mm.
Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars, and let me see what spring is like on a Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are
the planning commission here would not allow me to add more rooms in there. So how can I send my boys to college? So I said, we'll go to Van Nuys. It's not really in LA. Van Nuys is close to LA. It was a lot of work. For the first year, we owned the Golden Oaks. Edwin quit working for 1 year. He helped me work on that new facility.
Heaven, I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together, dancing cheek to cheek. Yes, heaven, I'm in heaven, and the kids that hung around me through the week.
In the late 2000,
2008, 2007.
Yeah, I noticed Edwin was becoming forgetful, mm-hmm. very insecure. He wants always to be next to me. Helen, where are you? I'm next to him. Then the passing by cars, they would call me, Helen, your husband is throwing again nuts to us in the car. I said, in 2005, I said, that's time. It is time to sell this property. I will take care of my husband. I took care of so many people here in America. We do not even know them. Mm-hmm. Now is my time to focus my attention on my husband. Mm-hmm. He knows when I'm going to park. Mm-hmm. Or no, don't go to that parking space. Don't park the car. Let's go down there. Back to St. Helena. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness, he was so happy. But I'm so happy I was able to serve him, mm-hmm. even if his mind was not there anymore. Hard work. And it's always God. As I look back, I always look God. Look to God who has been guiding me. Mm-hmm. In all these hardships, mm-hmm. God has been guiding me. Mm-hmm. And I thank him. I remember when we were here in, we went to Disneyland. I have Popeye and Roaring, Mama Roaring. Mm-hmm. We were in Disneyland. He said, Madi.
What's Madi?
Madi Kumadri. That means you call the wife, you call the mother of your son who is married to mm-hmm. him, you know, mm-hmm. his stepmother. Madi, talo tapa ang mayor sa Barcelona. We're better off than the mayor in Barcelona.
Oh my gosh.
Because here, look, we have Disneyland. Mm-hmm. We can see all these rides here, mm-hmm. and we get money every year, every mm-hmm. month. Mm-hmm. And Mama said, that's right. Mm-hmm. So that makes me really so happy, mm-hmm. that Papa is so happy with the way that I behaved, you know, as a child. Mm-hmm. I love my father and my mother, but when my mother died, all my love was to my Papa. Mm-hmm. And when Papa married Mama, she has all the girls, the kids. Mm-hmm. I have to take care of them. Mm-hmm. So I am used to hard work. That's why I always talk to my boys, you know. You have all the opportunities in America. We never have this in the Philippines. It was a very hard life there.
Yeah.
It's so hard, especially during the war. Mm. We have to walk 5 kilometers to go to church. And we have to go to the Japanese soldiers. But I said, make use of this. Now we find out that, you know, after all this, we cannot bring anything. Thank God for the opportunities He has given me, for my patience, for my hard work. Yeah. Otherwise, they would be all their suffering, yeah. in the poverty of the Philippines. I'm so brave, you know, how can I? Oh, hard work, very hard work.